and I was last week inside an all-white church. And in my mind, see, God had to renew my mind, because in my mind I'm saying, hold up, I can't come and be me, because guess what? I'm going in all these white churches. And so since I'm going in there, I got to be like what I see on TV. And God said, no. He said, you the one that they see. You the one that they want. And so you go in there and you be just like you have for its ministers. So I went in there like this. I said, and so being next thing you know, I start seeing white people. Ow! I said, oh my God. I say, I'm in the house. So next thing you know, I start walking heavy. I start walking big, because God transformed my mind. Can you hear what I'm saying? God transformed my mind. He told me like this. He said, if I anoint you, my anointing on you, it transcend culture, it transcend color, it transcend gender. You gotta understand, if you are anointed and appointed, you gotta understand there's white folks waiting on you, there's African Americans waiting on you, there's Jamaican waiting on you, there's Trinidad waiting on you. But guess what? You don't see it, because you have to transform your mind. Y'all don't understand me. Ain't no way in the world you be a part of me and you not able to get an overflow of that. You gotta understand. Oh my God. Oh Jesus. Come on up, y'all. Come on up. Y'all have a seat up. Welcome to man of God. Give the man of God a hand. Pray for us. You gotta understand that you gotta keep going in spite of what goes on. You can't get caught up with what people are saying and what people are doing. You gotta sit here and give God praise in spite of the situation. God trying to tell you, I'm trying to transform your mind. If I can transform your mind, see, if I don't touch your mind, you're going to look at this thing and you're going to look at it in a negative way. You're going to look at this trial that is trying to kill you. You're going to look at this trial that's trying to take you out. But when you can stand back footed on the word of God, then you understand that I have to count it on joy. When I fall into darkness, temptation, that all these things are working, I'm falling to glory. You got to understand that. You got to sit here and raise your hand and say, even though they slay me, yet what I trust in. You got to understand that no matter what you're going through, you got to say, what I'm going through, it's just a test. Come on, somebody need to get on their feet and say, it's just a test. Have you ever been watching a movie on TV? I'm talking that movie good. And next thing you know, something interrupt the thing and then, and they say, it's just a test. Oh, y'all better hear me. So God say, I'm trying to flip the house. And so now we watch it. When we be watching on HGTV, they go and buy the house. So they buy the house. They try to buy it for the lowest price. Oh my God. And that's how sin devalue us. Oh my God. The Bible say wages of sin. The wages of sin is what death. So now what happens is, in the eyes of society, I don't have no value. Y'all don't hear me. In the eyes of society, I'm nothing. Because they used to see me when I was walking barefooted. But they used to see me when I was out there homeless. They used to see me when I was going through some things. But now I got God on my side. And so now I got God on my side. Now I can walk amongst the people and say, I don't care what you say about me. What I'm saying. I don't care what you say, take some of the hands off. I don't care what you're saying about me. I don't care what you're saying. Because guess what? At the end of the day, only thing that matters is what God say and what my children say and what my wife say. You can talk about me. I don't care nothing about all that. But I tell you what, God ain't delivered me from fighting. Put your hands on me. You got to see what I'm playing with then, baby. Because I tell you, you got to understand, God ain't made us to be no fool. With the devil every day. And when we pray, our prayers, this is what our prayers do in the spirit. The Bible says that Satan is the power and prince of the air, right? When we pray here, it's at this level. When our prayer ascends up, it goes in his level, right?
So what it does, it's slapping.
Come on.
Y'all ain't catch that.
Because it
moved him out of the way. Because guess what had to happen? When it moved him out of the way, the prayer got to go on top. That's why when Daniel, he said, we got your prayer. But guess what? It was holding up the answer. Y'all don't understand, the answer was held up. But the prayer went up. Y'all look at me. And though he said the prayer had made it through. But when the answer was coming down. Y'all don't understand. That's why you got to hold on. You may see he made the prayer. The prayer done made it up. You got to be faithful. That's why he said patience possess you your what? See, but that's what's wrong with people. They ain't got no patience now. Everybody want it now. I want it that now. I want to be a big baller now. I want this thing.